Hello friends, in this lecture we will discuss about basic introduction of Java language. In this lecture we cover these topics in brief. So now let's begin with a brief history of Java. Java is a high level programming language that is concurrent, object oriented, class based and portable across platforms. It is developed by Sun Microsystems and intended to let application developers write once and run anywhere. This language is created by James Gosling and with its team Mike Sheridan and Patrick Norton. This language first released in 1991. At that time, its name is Oak. In the year 1995, its name changed to Java. The most special thing about Java in relation to other languages is that it lets you write special programs called applets. What do you mean by applets? Applets can be downloaded from the internet and played safely within a web browser. This is all about brief history of Java. Now I will define definition of Java. Java is a simple, object-oriented, distributed, interpreted, robust, secure, architecture-neutral, portable, high-performance, multi-threaded dynamic language. This definition is given by James Gosling. So this is all about definition. Now I will introduce you with some additions of Java. According to Sun Microsystems, 3 billion devices run Java. There are many devices where Java is currently used. Some of them we will discuss here. So let's start with first edition. Is a J2SE or Java Standard Edition. This is the core Java programming platform. It contains all libraries and applications, programming interfaces that any Java programmer should learn. It contains packages like java.lang, java.input/output, java.math and many more. It includes mainly desktop applications like Acrobat Reader, Media Player, Antivirus, etc. Second edition is a Java 2EE or Java Enterprise Edition. You will use this edition only when your application demands a very large scale distributed system. Then you should use this Enterprise Edition. It provides libraries for database access, web services, Java server pages, servlets, and many others. It includes applications such as irctc.co.in websites or banking applications. So this is all about second edition. Now move to third edition. Third edition is a J2ME or Java Micro Edition. If you want to develop applications for mobile devices and embedded systems such as set-top boxes, then Micro Edition is helpful. It includes applications such as smart cards, robotics, and many others comes under these editions. Okay, this is all about editions of Java. Now, next are the trade-offs. While coding, keep these trade-offs in your mind. First one is ease of use versus power, safety versus efficiency, rigidity versus extensibility. Firstly, I will tell you what trade-off means. It means if you want to achieve a balance between these two desirable incompatible features, then we have to keep these trade-offs in our mind to make our code best, better and good one. Okay, now this is all about trade-offs. Now we will discuss features of Java. Skipping this first one, feature, I will discuss this later on. So come to second feature, platform independent and portable. How it is platform independent and portable? In this, it means that the program executed on any platform without using compiler. We don't use any compiler for compiling our code. We just run and use our application which we developed. Okay, third feature is object oriented approach. I want to tell you basic paradigm before discussing this approach. There are basically two paradigms. One is process oriented and another one is object oriented. Process oriented means that how the things are done, that is the way, the method and its mechanism. In object oriented approach, it considers the data first, after that it follows the process oriented approach. So this is the object oriented approach. Now next feature is robust and secure. It is a robust and secure due to these features, because it in Java we have automatic garbage collection and exception handling. So that's the reason Java is robust and secure. Next is distributed. Fifth feature is distributed. Java has the capability of sharing data and programs, making the multiple programmers to work on a single task while sitting at remote locations. This is the distributed feature. Okay, next feature is multi-threaded. As you know that Java is inherently multi-threaded. It means a single Java program can have many different threads executing independently and continuously. For example, on the same page, three processes can run together with each getting equal time from the CPU with very little efforts. So this all comes under multi-threaded. Next feature is simple. This language is simple to learn, understand and use. The last feature is extensibility and dynamic. How it is extensible? It is extensible as it supports the functions written in another languages like C and C++. How it is dynamic? It is dynamic because programs carry some amount of runtime type information that is used to verify, resolve, use, assess to objects at runtime. These all are the features of Java. Now I will discuss the feature number one, that is compiled and interpreted. How it is compiled and interpreted? We know that the compiler compiles a program at once and interpreter interprets the program line by line. See this diagram. After writing a code in a Java language, it is saved with .java extension. And converts it into a class file, that is .class extension. The process between converting .java file to .class file, this all conversion is done by JVM. JVM makes Java platform independent. It is treated as an interpreter and the machine is relevant to hardware, and this machine is relevant to hardware. After this conversion process, you got the .class file which is to be called as Java bytecode, This is the file which we use on any platform to run our application. This is all about how our code is compiled and interpreted. Now we will discuss the OOPS concepts. In short, I will discuss in further video lectures. We will discuss in detail. First concept is abstraction. Abstraction means hiding the complexity and providing only relevant information to user. For example, ATM, MS Word, scientific calculator. Second concept is encapsulation. It means binding up of data and the methods that operate on that data within a single unit known as class is considered as an encapsulation. It is done from outside environment. This encapsulation is totally done from outside the environment. Next is the inheritance. Inheritance is the mechanism of driving a new class from already created class. It is a process by which one object requires the another object. Fourth concept is polymorphism. It means many forms. Poly means many and morphos means forms, so its meaning is many forms. It is the process in which internal structure of the processes changes to external interfaces. For example, mobile phones has further forms, for example, multimedia phones, Android phones, Apple phones. This is the concept of polymorphism. Now understand this syntax properly. This is the syntax of Java language. Every Java code starts with a class keyword. This is a keyword. Class is a keyword. And this is a class name. Syntax is a class name. We write here ABC name also. Next is public static void main string any name. This is the function, main function, from where Java code begins to run the program. So what do you mean by public? Public is a access specifier. And JVM assess this public specifier. Static. Static is a keyword that allows the main function to be called without having to initialize a particular instant. Next is a void. It does not return any type. Then we have a string any names. Here we write string S letter in capital, and this is the arguments or that is the array collection of array type. Here string any name is the arguments of type string your Java application accepts when you run this, when you run your program. String is a data type. Okay, so this is all about the syntax of Java. One thing I want to tell you that we can also write our main function syntax as shown to you here. We can begin our main function with static, public, void, main, string, any name. So this is all about the syntax of Java. So I want to stop my introduction here. This is all about Java introduction. In the next video, I will show you the steps to install Java and how to run your basic program code. So this is all about. At last, but not least. Let's understand the meaning of these words. Appricity. Appricity means the warmth of the sun in winter. Scherzando. It means playful. Third one is abstain. It means choose not to consume. So this is all about meanings. So thank you so much.